चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः वंशाकल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपासिन्धुभ्यैव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो महाबदन्याय कृष्णप्रेमप्रदायते कृष्णाय कृष्ण चैतन्य नाम्ने गौरतिशे हे कृष्ण करुणा सिंधो दीन बंधो जगतपते गोपेश गोपिका कांत राधा कांत नमस्तु तप्त कंचन गौरांगी राधे वृंदावनेश्वरी विषभानुसुते देवी प्रणमामि वृंदायै तुलसी दव्यै प्रियायै केशवस्य च कृष्ण भक्ति प्रदे देवी सत्यवत्यै नमो श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर शिवास आदि शिव हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई ऑफर माय Pushpanjali in the lotus feet of my डिवाइन मास्टर ओम विष्णुपाल श्रीमद भक्ति प्रज्ञान केशव गोस्वामी महाराज एंड अंडर द लोटस फीट ऑफ मेरे शिक्षा गुरु नित्य लीला प्रोष्ट ओम विष्णुपाल श्री भक्ति वेदांत स्वामी महाराज एंड टू ऑल और डिसिपलिक आचार्य फ्रॉम कृष्ण अप टू नाउ
pertama-tama saya menyampaikan semua sujud kepada guru kerohanian saya tercinta.
I told a very important shlok which has told by Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur like essence of or whole teachings from Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and up to now. I want that the preachers, though, who preaches all these places, they should always remind this shloka, remember this shloka. आराध्यो भगवान ब्रजेश तनयस्तद्धाम वृंदावनम रम्या काचित् उपासना बजुबधुबरगेन जाकल्पिता श्रीमद्भागवतम प्रमाण अमलम प्रेमापुमर्थो महा श्री चैतन्य महाप्रभुर मतमिदं तत्रादरो नापरः दिस श्लोक इन दिस श्लोक very brief, everything has come. Like Aradhyo Bhagavan Braje Shatanayah, we see in India or everywhere there are so many god and goddess. In India, we see Ganesh, Lakshmi, Sun, Shakti, Durga, and Vishnu, prominent five, but there are innumerous gods and goddesses. All are worshipable. But in Indian Vedic knowledge, from beginning in Vedas, in Purans, in Srimad Bhagavatam, especially in Gita, it has been taken the essence of all Vedas, that there should be one supreme personality of Godhead. God means G-O-D, G generator, O operator, and D destruction of all universe. You should explain. In Bible we see only one God. In Quran Sharif we see only Khuda or God, Khuda or Allah. But in India we see there is no number at all of God and Goddesses. So some may be in confusion that there should be one God. Why so many gods? So Vedas has told that there is no so many gods, only one God. In whole universe, in all countries, and lakhs and lakhs universe, there must be one God. No so many gods. Then how to reconcile all these things? They are told. In India, Gita we know that Krishna told that lakhs and lakhs years before, I have told the Atma-gyan to son. And Vedas has been told that only one God. Then why so many gods? Kali, Durga, Shiva, Hanuman and all others, so many. According to the stages of jivas, souls, there are several classes. Where there is only one class in anywhere, then it means that there is no good study there. Though it may be only one class of PhD or D.Litt or anyone, anything. But I think that all are not qualified to study in one class PhD. Everywhere there are so many classes. So in Vedic culture we see there are no several gods. Only one. But what are they? Ganesh, Shankar and all others in Gita in very short words, it has been told that they are all vibhuti. Vibhuti. Under one God. Like in a country there is a president, chief minister or
prime minister.
So many group of ministers, so many officers, so many top to bottom, lakhs and lakhs in that government to control any country. So to control all universe, lakhs and lakhs, there must be one God, Supreme Personality of Godhead, and all others, vibhuti, having some power from Him and controlling all under their God. So, this is like so many classes from lower class to highest classes. If there is one class, there will be no study for all classes of persons. So to do it perfect, all these are stages. So we should not disobey any of the gods, semi-gods. Don't disobey. But you should see that all are not equal to the highest, that is Krishna. Name anything be, in different languages, no heart. But in which the highest topic of three things, G-O-D, is situated in that person, then we will think that he is the person, Supreme Personality of Godhead. So India, it has been decided by Krishna Himself. In Vedas also, in Mahabharata also, everywhere. But it wants some quality to know all these things. How we will know this? Who is Supreme God? It has been told that all living entity wants three things. Where there is perfect Sat, Chit and Ananda. Sat means we don't want to die. We don't want to be old. We don't want that we should have so many diseases, and in the old days our teeth will go, eyes will be weak, and thus we cannot take a glass of water and die. So anyone does not want to be, but they are bound to be like so. So those who never dies, he is perfect, and he makes us also not to die. Always in same condition, in same shape, love and affection and everything perfect in that. So this is called Sat. Chit means knowledge. From boyhood, oh, what is this father, mother, what is this? Learning so much, learning so much. But we cannot be never perfect knowledge we cannot gain. Where there is perfect knowledge, everything knowing, how this world was created. Who nurses us in the womb of mother? Who gives this
intelligence?
All things where there is the perfect knowledge, he is Supreme Personality. Where is the perfect Sat? Sat means Satta.
Entity.
Entity. Never changes, nothing. Always like in the same. And we want all to be happy. To be happy is called Ananda. We have some Ananda, some happy in this world, in our family, if there is love and affection. But it is not perfect in any being of whole world. Even not in goddesses. Sometimes they quarrel. Sometimes so many problems for them. So all are not happy. Supreme must be happy, and by him happiness, pure happiness may come. So far there is perfect happiness, that is called Ananda. To make also other Anandama and himself he. So where the Sat Chit Ananda, in perfect, in last stage, extreme, he is called Supreme Personality of Godhead. All are Godhead, maybe. We are also some part of God, so we are, when we will gain some more knowledge, we can be called somewhat a part of God. So Jeev has been called Brahma. No harm, but not perfect. Where there is perfect, all these three things. Especially the six appellants. I will explain further. You should do. Where there is Sat, Chit and Ananda. He is called Supreme Personality of Godhead. There are six kinds of affluent. It must be in full or fullest in that personality of Godhead. And that is our first shape. he must have a beautiful shape. Among all shapes, that all will be charmed. And if he has no shape, beautiful shape, then how he can create all these things? Like he is the seed of all, if there is not anything, potency in seed of all kinds of shapes, there must be all kinds of shape in him, head personality of Godhead. If there is no there, no shape, then he cannot create this world. So a beautiful shape. And that shape be so much beautiful that it can charm all God, Goddesses, all living creatures, everyone. And in that shape, if there is no shape, he cannot create. There is no potency of shapes in him, it's him. That if there is no potency of all these things, he cannot be accepted as God. Secondly, all kinds of virtues should be in him, in fullest, highest way.
In extreme stage.
And extreme. Everybody. What is that? First, knowledge. Sampurna Gyan. All kinds of knowledge are in strain in that. Secondly, all kinds of aishwarya.
Affluence.
Affluence. He can be the smallest, anurapi anyan mahato api mahiyan, biggest, largest, in which whole world is situated, and in every parts of the world, very
atom,
in atom, more than atom, if there is, in that he is in full way. This is called aishwarya. He can do anything that a man cannot do, a god cannot do, goddess cannot do. Third, this shape. Fourth, Gyan, first, Aishwarya, Aishwarya, Samagrasya, Virija. Who should be very, very
powerful
to do anything. There is none like him. But secondless person.
One without a second.
His God may be, so many gods are, they may be so powerful, but he must be most powerful. He can control all. And vairagya. Vairagya means?
Renounce.
Renounce. If there is no renounce, then he will be like other, we.
A real person.
He will be attached anywhere. And he will cry for his father, mother, wife and all others, his children. So these are six appellants. And Jasa. Jasa means?
Fame.
Topmost fame should be there. None is like him, so much famous. His name is famous. His appellants are famous. All the qualities are famous. He is so merciful that no comparison at all. Causeless merciful. He has so much affection and love for all, anyone cannot have. So all these appellants, qualities, shape, gyan, vairagya, all should be in highest stays in that God. So if any of the these six and these three is not found an extreme, then he is not God. He may be God, but not Supreme Personality of God. Not only in Vedas and Indian scripts. Also we see in Bible, God created man after his own image. Means, God has created man as his shape was. So it seems that Bible admits this, that Supreme Personality of God has shape, he has some wishes, he is so kind, so all attributes are there. Also we see in Quran Sharif, Muhammadan, that Anna Laha Khalaka Man Surat Hi. It means that Khuda has created man as his shape is. So there is wish, there is shape, there are so many qualities, and everything is there. So all these scriptures are like Vedas, somewhat different. But in this way, we see that everywhere it has been admitted, that I told before, that Krishna has saved, God has saved, so many attributes, six affluence, three Satchid Ananda, everything should be topest in that personality. Without sin.
Jadi di seluruh dunia ini kita sudah melihat tidak ada sesuatu pun tanpa bentuk.
Water has shape, we see. But can you define that? What is that shape? Water has sense. Scientists are telling, water has no shape, water has no color, water is tasteless, colorless. Why they are telling? We see the shape of water, we taste the water's taste, it has own its any taste, but any taste mixes this worldly, and it makes like that, but it has its own taste, own color, but any color can come in that. So we cannot define, so we say like this. So how we can define Krishna? That he has so many shapes, so many tests, so many all attributes. So sometimes in Vedas or anywhere it has been told that he is a nirguna. But actually the meaning is not that. Nirguna means he has all the qualities, shapes and everything beyond aprakriti and beyond our knowledge and all of that. So he is nirgun, so he is shapeless there, but he has all shapes, all attributes above maya. That is it itself. Like water we cannot define, so why, how we can define Krishna or Supreme Personality of Godhead? We cannot define. In epics, in Vedas, in Puran, in Srimad Bhagavatam, in Gita, what is the conception of what?
Supreme Personality
of God. About 5,000 years before, a baby came as the son of Vasudev and Devaki. Very beautiful son. Like clouds, his color. His name was kept Krishna. Why Krishna? He can attract all universe, all the souls, all creatures and living entity by his shape, by his attributes, by his affluence, by his everything. So he came, when Vasudev and Devaki were given in jail in Mathura, there in the night he came at the son of Vasudev and Devaki, four-handed. Very beautiful shape and so many, having four weapons: Shankha, Chakra, Gada, Padma. And at the same time, same moment, he took birth in Gokul as the son of Nanda and Yashoda. There he was two-handed, a baby, like a baby, quite naked, as a baby. And here in Mathura, four-handed, age about 16, very young, very powerful, the hairs were
carved
and so long, having ornaments, golden
ornaments,
or chintamani ornaments, like kastubh mani, and so many things, decorated with so many ornaments. And he's speaking so much, he spoke with so much with Devaki and Vasudev here. And they are like a baby, nothing, in two shapes, here and there. Not only this, this Krishna, afterward, in his pastimes, he became lakhs and lakhs with each gopi in Vrindavan. And he became lakhs and lakhs there in Dwarka, in 16,108 Krishna. So we are seeing so much affluence in that. And so love and affection in what? An extreme love and affection. Love so that even deers, serpents, elephants, all others, Indra, Brahma, Vishnu, Mahesh, all were attracted and controlled by him. So all these things, qualities, what I told, exist in Krishna. So our Vedas, Upanishad, and all scriptures had admitted undoubtedly this fact, this truth, fundamental truth, the Krishna is
Supreme
Personality of Godhead. It has been clearly written, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, what is the opinion about this? So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's opinion, he is telling that, Aradhyo Bhagavan Braje Satanayas Tat Dhamma Vrindavan. Aradhyo Bhagavan Braje Satanaya. He has told the Supreme Personality of Godhead is Brajendranandan Shyam Sundar, that is the son of Nanda. He has not told the son of Vasudev Devaki. Why he has told like this? In Srimad Bhagavat, we can see, if you have read the book of Swamiji, explanation, Bhaktivedanta Swami, it has been clearly written in Srimad Bhagavat that he came from Vasudev and Devaki in Mathura, first. But after that, Sukadeva Goswami has several times he has told, son of Nanda, son of Yashoda, everywhere, not less than 100 times, Yashoda Nandana, Nanda Nandana. So in this sloka it is told that Brajendanandan Shyam Sundar. Why it has been told? Krishna from Mathura and Krishna in Vrindavan, Gokul. They are same. No difference at all. In Bhagavata, in affluence, in everything. But there is some speciality in Brajendananda. Both they are same. By tattva.
Theory.
But Krishna, Brajendanandan, where he is telling, that he has so much prema and affection, love and everything there. That is called rasa. So much this affection and love in Krishna, that is not so much in Devakinanda. That is why he has been called Aradhyo Bhagavan Brajesha Tanayaha. Swamiji has clearly written this. First he told like Srimad Bhagavatam, in it is written by Parikshit Maharaj and Sukadeva Goswami. But after that, when Krishna is there in Vrindavan, he has undoubtedly told several times. By appellance he is here also, in Gokul also, in Golok Vrindavan also, in all universe, in lakhs and kotis shapes. This is his affluent, Aishwarya. But yet, that little boy comes of Gokul, who has taken birth in the womb of Yashoda Maiya by Nanda Baba in Gokul, he is Aradhya. Now we will come on the point how and why he is called Supreme Personality of Godhead. The Devakinandan, Krishna 400, was brought to Gokul and he mixed in the Yashodanandan and became one, because he is one. Purnamadah, Purnamidah, Purnata Purnamu Duchyate, Purnasya Purnameva Adaya. So, when they were separated, even they were Purna. When they are mixing, even they are Purna. In any way, in all stages, Krishna is full. So now you know that both mixed in Gokul. One day, this little boy Krishna, quite naked, was playing in Brahmanda Ghat. Those who have gone with me in Braja, they know Brahmanda Ghat. A very good, famous ghat, bathing place of Gokul on the river Jamuna. Krishna was playing with so many boys. Dham, Sidham, Sudham, Vasudham, Sto, Krishna, Lavanga, Arjun. So many. Hundred and thousand of. All naked. Somewhere, 2 days younger. Four days, 15 days younger, 1 month, and somewhere 4 days elder, 15 days elder, like Baldev Prabhu, 15 days older, or others. All were naked. They are playing here, there, with the sands of Jamuna, making walls and rooms by sands, sometimes one breaking, sometimes playing, sometimes struggling, wrestling and doing all. Hide, playing the play of hiding and seek. At last, all boys became in one group with Baldev Prabhu, and Krishna was only alone in one party. And all were clapping and laughing boys, making so much clapping to Krishna,
joking. Making fun of him.
That from where you came? Because your mother is golden color, your father is golden color, but among them how you came this black? So all were clapping. Krishna was not understanding why they are clapping and laughing so much. He began to ask, why you are clapping and laughing? Then Madhumangal came forward and told, oh, I should say that you are not the son of, really the son of Nanda and Yashoda. Why not? Proof is that you are black, your father and mother are golden color, so you are not the son. Then saw Krishna, oh, I am black. And began to do and he left the playing with the boys and he ran to his home, to Yashoda mother. But now he was so much weeping. He has so much pain here that I am not the son of my mother. And they are telling with proof that I am black and they are
golden.
So all boys were clapping, also following and coming. Like this, you know?
Yeah.
What?
Making joke.
So please, Krishna came to his mother and became wept so bitterly, falling down on the courtyard. And not today, mother. Only weeping. Yashoda came and tried to take Krishna in his lap. But Krishna today was so angry and weeping that he used to come down from the lap. Like this, no? Sleeping, like slipper.
Yeah, sliding off.
And he was more and more loudly, louder, crying and weeping. Yashoda told them, why my son, why you are weeping? And began to do like this. Don't weep, tell me what is the fact. Why you are weeping? At last, when he became some remedy, then he began to tell that I am not your son, so I am now going to forest anywhere. Why you are telling so? All boys are clapping and telling. Even Baldev, Dau Bhaiya, my brother, elder brother, he's telling like so and clapping, so I am not your son. They are telling that any other person, any other mother has yielded you and you have been kept in a tree.
Cave of a tree.
Anyone. And Nanda Baba got, because we are weeping, and he took it and gave it to Mother Yashoda. Actually, you are not son. So when Krishna told it, and weeping bitterly, and he was a little baby, but he was ready to go for shine anywhere, that I will give up my life, I will not be here. Then Yashoda Ma took the oath of Narayan, and on his own head, that I'm telling you, by the oath of Narayan, I'm touching Narayan and Tulasi, you have come from my own womb, and all Brijavasi are witness for this. They are seen. So I cannot tell lie. The boys can tell lie only to joke you, yes. But I'm telling you, by oath, that you are my son. And he took anyhow and gave his breast, and then Krishna was somewhat satisfied. So how he has affection and skill of charming all. So Vedas has told that Krishna is supreme personality. In Gita, Krishna has himself told, nanyat mattah parataram nanyat kisnati asti dhanam vedaisya sarvam aham eva vidyah sarvadharman parityajyamam. We will explain all these things, very little and very beautiful stories, and explain that how much Siddhanta are in this. Today is now going to be 8. He should explain, it will be 8, then we will go all there and we will see the dance of the little babies. And tomorrow you should be ready to hear something more sweet pastimes of Krishna. Hare Krishna.
Pada suatu hari, Sri Krishna bermain dengan